Hi, I'm Claire and I'm from the Chief Procurement Office. I joined TMR as a contractor in January 2019, so approximately 2 years ago. And I've also been an active member with the Indigenous Employee Network. I joined TMR in 2019 to drive the procurement control self-assessment. Following that, I started work on the TMR Procurement Forum, chairing the procurement regional networks with PDO and Roadtech. And then I've been identified as the Queensland Indigenous Procurement Champion for TMR. So that's led into the TMR Indigenous Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Buyer's Guide being produced, which we're just about to implement. The Buyer's Guide has been brought about to cover and go across all of TMR's four procurement frameworks and to act as a best practice guide for buyers to assist them in understanding what resources are available within the agency, what supports are there to assist them to put those practices into motion, as well as to encourage them to engage with Aboriginal businesses and include them into tendering for these government contracts, and as such contribute to the Queensland government target of 3% spend by 2022. Indigenous procurement is about using our contracts and our spend to influence the people, places and communities of Queensland. And we do that by looking at the audiences that will receive benefit from the contracts that we have, by understanding the businesses who we can invite to tender and engage with, and then in turn, how they will deliver those products and services and who they'll engage with within the supply market. So the guide promotes TMR's corporate membership with Supply Nation. It looks at best practice principles of Indigenous procurement as well. So it looks at how we can include the employment and training components into contracts to drive and influence change. But not only that, it looks at not only the high value funding required components of a contract, but looking at how us as buyers can influence change through low value, low risk contracts through the diversity and complexity of so many different contracts that we can invite Indigenous businesses to tender for and become engaged with and in turn spur on business growth and development within Queensland. So COVID's had a bit of an impact about how we as buyers think about engaging with businesses, and it's sort of brought to the forefront how procurement drives to include social change, economic change, cultural changes. So at the moment there's the drive for social procurement. Well, Indigenous businesses have the potential to drive that change, not only just as a local supplier, but within the communities that are originally placed and even remote. So by looking at the audiences that can be influenced, not only just as a community, but within a family unit itself. So employment and training changes the dynamics of a family's well-being and worth, and in turn that can influence the local sporting team, the local business at the corner, and even Indigenous businesses are more likely to engage other Indigenous businesses. So it spurs on the supply chain, and that's important for Queensland's economic delivery.